Staying on mining matters, South Africa's recently enacted mining charter has neglected exploration. Industry players attending a conference in Joburg are, however, generally happy with the new law. They say it's essentially workable. CGTN's Angelo Coppola explains why.
South Africa attracts just 1% of the global exploration expenditure. On the other hand, Australia and Canada individually attract some 15% each.
Within that 1%, 90% is spent on brownfields as opposed to greenfields. So we need a lot more investment of that risk capital, which we know is risk capital of exploration, into exploration so that we can actually get the project pipeline, so we can get new developments, new mines in the South African context. So the upside is huge, but we do need that exploration boom.
The reason for the lack of exploration in South Africa, an analyst says, is due to the historic ownership patterns, where the big miners only explored and searched for new ore bodies when the need arose. There are lessons to be learned from other mining jurisdictions.
Exploration is an incentivized activity. The government, the people, own the mineral rights, and therefore they have the responsibility to make people come explore. Our country has never got a mind around it. We don't want to incentivize people, and so people go to where they are incentivized.
The mining charter may have reassured existing mine owners, but it's left the junior miners and exploration companies out in the cold.
The problem is, when you are faced with an immediate 30% giveaway of any junior mine that you start, it's very, very difficult to make the numbers make sense. And that is the big problem. There are lots of people out there who are looking at ore bodies, who are really keen on starting mines, but they cannot raise the money. And the reason they can't raise the money is because of all these giveaways and a whole lot of other rules too. The fact that you have to procure so much locally now, the fact that you have to appoint certain people according to certain quotas, it's not a good way to run a mine.
Risk Capital understands the challenges in mining exploration globally, but if the incentives are in place, investors would be more inclined to come to South Africa.
Yes, we all want to, drill that one hole that make you a billionaire, but you drill many, many holes at millions of dollars of expense before you get that lucky. And that's really part of the overall challenge that we face as a country.
With the mining charter now gazetted, it's moving on to the next stage and getting the exploration investors back into South Africa. It's going to be a tough ask. I'm Angelo Coppola for CGTN in Johannesburg, South Africa.